pleasures.
So I think you've preempted a little bit my following question, which is great. How has digital technology impacted access to pluralism of news and information online?
Well, first, you can see here a first answer. In 2011, 2012, we are talking here about people reading newspapers, essentially, okay? That is one of the elements of media, but not the only one, but one important element of the legacy media. In 2011, 2012, 40% of people were reading a newspaper every day. In 2022, this is halved. They are 21%. The decrease, the decline of the traditional media, watching this in the newspaper world, but this is the same for almost all the traditional media, is very rapid. And this is a very complicated issue. What is the, why platforms have a responsibility on this? Well, it's a complex issue, but let's have a look at it. Platforms have a series of, the world of platform is showing us an increased tendency of people to access news, not anymore choosing a media, but to through this pre-existing views organizing platforms that we are studying, the fact that they have accentuated polarization and decreased the number of sources to which people are exposed. So we have a world of theoretically a lot of information available to people, but really people are accessing less information. Then we have in the special moment of electoral campaigns, a lot of profiling, a specific target advertising, and this is a problem for democracy, obviously. And then we have also a lot of computational propaganda, robots, bots that send information to people, misleading them, and a lot of disinformation. This is the picture, but from where this picture comes from? Why we are seeing this? Well, we are seeing this because platforms that are a multi-sided market have a very strong market power because they have a model, an economic model, a business model that is superior to the model of the traditional media. They are able to connect a group of agents. They are able to use indirect network externality in a most effective way than traditional media used to do. And so they are able to, and nobody can really react to this because agents cannot bypass platforms. What are the economic effects of this? Well, the economic effects are that platforms are different from traditional media. In traditional media, there were situations of concentration of traditional media, but essentially there was some competition among the televisions, among the newspapers, among the radios, and so on, the sources of information. Here we have a situation in which winner takes all or winner takes most. That's what we are seeing, dynamics in which dominant companies are quasi-monopolies, or in a way are very, very strong, and these are global companies all over. So what we can say is that in the digital markets, competition has become something that is not competition in the market. And competition in the markets is some sort of plurality of offer, but is competition for the market. Who wins the market, who tips the market, gets it all. And this is the issue we are seeing. What are the consequences for media? Well, sorry, first, let me say that this means that these major companies have huge resources. We can see here they can buy other companies with very important investments. Sometimes they buy companies close to their activity, sometimes they look into the future. And this is something that is happening all over. We have an example of Meta, but I can have an example of Alphabet, Google, Microsoft, Amazon. All these are companies that are able to invest a lot, and their ability to invest to buy other companies is growing. So we are seeing real giants here developing. Well, let's come back to media. What is the effect of this on media? Well, you see, media, traditional media, were able at least in theory, to have a role of platforms in which they had a sort of double ability to finance themselves. They had viewers, readers, and so on that would pay a newspaper or subscribe for a pay television, or even there would be models in which they were financed directly by the advertising. And plus they had advertising. So they had these two sources of financing, but without a clear ability to mix these things. This is a model of traditional, in a sense, with two possible sources of financing. Well, what platform have done is create a new business model in which, for instance, major social networks are at the middle within a triangle of advertisers, users, and content providers, but in which all these forces interact and uses the resources, the information. Sometimes users don't pay anything. The price is zero in most of this platform because the interaction of content providers, advertisers, a user's activity creates such an important ability to exploit the information and the data acquired and to do target advertising that this becomes really the source of a general source of financing for this platform. But the effect for the media is that there is no more the source of financing advertising for traditional media, because this kind of advertising is so much technically superior that is taking most of the advertising. But there is another element. It's not only taking most of the advertising, but it's also spreading information in a way in which it's difficult to price information. And so the traditional media not only lose on the advertising size, but they lose also on the ability to sell the news, the professional news created by media are difficult to sell anymore. The willingness to pay for information by the consumer is somehow dispersed by this economic model. So the impact on the media industry or platform is they separate information from the physical media. And this is a first element. You are not anymore able to make money out of creating information. They jeopardize the pricing decision because non-monetary metrics, most of these social platforms provide news for free, apparently. In reality, they get information, they get data in exchange, and then they do advertising, very, very targeted advertising. But the effect is that traditional media cannot anymore or have the enormous difficulty to price their information. The marginal cost of storing, processing, and distribution this information is very, very low for these platforms. And they reduce transaction costs. So you see, there is the positive of spreading information in a way that is almost apparently for free. But the cost is that the creators of most of this information, because this platform don't create information, they are not media in that sense, they are not content providers, but the cost for traditional and professional content providers is that they are unable to have advertising sources or to sell their information. So, as I was explaining, the digitalization negatively affected the two main sources of revenue for traditional media, sales to readers and viewers and advertising. Let's have a look at the picture that gives us the feeling for this. Advertising revenue of new and old player. You can see in this table, in the past 13 years, the New York Times lost 77%. I'm talking about the New York Times, so not really, let's say, a very important newspaper. 77% of its advertising revenue. In the same time, more or less in the same years, Facebook advertising revenue jumped up by 15,000%. And the response is that it's very difficult to be a media in this environment. And as we say, there's not only the advertising, but it's also the ability to sell news.